Hello everybody, this is Mohan, co-founder of IAS Baba. Today we have All India Rank 4, Soumya Pandey with us. She was our ILP student. Hearty congratulations for you on behalf of the entire IAS Baba team.
First of all, what is your feeling now?
I'm
being the top, yeah. One of the toppers of
yes. I'm feeling really, really very blessed and I'm feeling really happy. And I'm thankful to God that I got selected with rank 4 in my first attempt. So it's a really very good feeling.
Can you introduce yourself?
So my name is Soumya Pandey and I have secured All India Rank 4 in Civil Services exam this year. This was my first attempt and my background is that I've done B.Tech in Electrical Engineering from MNNIT Allahabad and I graduated in 2015. I prepared for 1 year, that is 15 to 16, and I appeared in 16. And I prepared from my hometown Allahabad itself, so I did not go to Delhi or somewhere else for coaching. And I think, and I followed a lot of online initiatives.
Why UPSC?
Right. So I chose UPSC. Actually, when I was in class 12, I topped my district in CBSE board. That time, State Bank of India had felicitated us, and there for the first time I had interacted with some students who that year had qualified civil services. That's when I came to know what civil services is all about, what these services are and how it can bring a change in life of so many people. So I had decided that after engineering, I will try at least one or two times for these services because I found these to be really impactful for the society.
How did you prepare for the exam, basically all three stages from prelims to mains to interview?
Right. So I'll segregate and I'll tell. Actually, you cannot segregate, it's an integrated approach, but there are a little bit of differences and nuances in each of the three stages. So I'll start with prelims. For prelims, the most important thing is that first you cover all the basic books. So what I tried to do is that first I read all the NCRTs from class 6 to 12, at least two times I read those. So that at least I'm thorough with my basics. Yes, and I would like to mention here that I have joined IAS Baba ILP. So I was following that regularly in that they had for all important topics, they used to give infographics and mind maps. So I used to follow them and I used to add them with my NCRT. So I used to like combine both of them to for my knowledge. And for prelims, so I read all the basic books. After that, I practiced a lot of mock papers. So particular emphasis I should give on IAS Baba 60-day plan because I followed it thoroughly. And yes, and the daily quiz initiatives that used to come, I used to solve it every night. And first I used to go through the current affairs of IAS Baba daily, and then I used to solve the quiz. And then just 2 months before prelims, I used to follow this 60-day event, and I did mock papers from some other coaching also. So like this was my strategy for prelims. And in prelims, everything is very unpredictable, so you have to be ready with your static question also, with your current affairs also. Like in our case in 2016, the paper was heavily weighted towards current affairs. So it's important that you are abreast with all the important things that are happening around you. So one thing that I did was I used to watch news also every day on television, like DD News or some other important news in which actually the news is shown and not the prime time shows in which other things are shown. So this prelims means very important that you know all the nuances of current affairs. And I also followed that IAS Baba's PIB thing, because that actually in PIB there are many things that you miss out generally. So you can follow that for the PIB thing. Then coming to the mains. For mains, it's as you know, the mains is the most elaborate part of this exam and it's the most important part, which will actually make your name into the list or it can take you out of the list. So it's important that in mains you give equal emphasis on all the four GS papers, on the essay paper, and on your optionals. So for should I elaborate on all the GS papers differently?
Yeah.
Okay. So for essay, let me start with GS paper 1. In GS paper 1, basically you have art and culture, you have history, Indian society, and geography. So for art and culture, I followed a book of Nitin Singhania. I read that book completely, and I also, yes, of course, you will have to follow IAS Baba. You know, they give small matters, mind maps, you keep on adding them along with your regular things. And ILP also, this everything is very systematic, so you do follow that. So in art and culture, I did this. In history, I had followed Bipin Chandra for modern India. For ancient and medieval, I did not do much. I had just read the NCRTs. For society, again, NCRTs I thought was enough. And for geography, because geography was my optional, so I had prepared geography there, so I did not put much emphasis here. So this was GS paper 1. Then coming to GS paper 2, which includes constitution, governance and international relations. So yes, of course GS paper 2, we have seen in the last few years that GS paper 2 is heavily current oriented. So it's better that you don't waste your time in static things and focus more on the current things that are happening. You will be reading in prelims Lakshmikant book, which is of polity, so you will be good with your facts and all that. But in mains, you have to apply those. And I think the IS Baba daily current affairs that they give, they usually take two important topics and they cover it thoroughly. So that helped me a lot in answer writing in GS paper 2. So I would recommend that you follow that for your GS papers, particularly paper 2. Then for paper 3, you have economics, science and technology, internal security and
environment.
So this GS paper 3 is also heavily current oriented, so here also, because economics is usually you have to it's almost all current things. So again, I think IS Baba daily current events and the ILP played a very, very important role here also, because I was not going for any regular coaching as such, so I think I was totally dependent on this ILP for my this thing. And then GS paper 4, of course, is ethics. In that I practiced a few case studies of last few years. My ethics paper did not go well. This time they had asked a lot of questions factually, like the John Rawl question on social justice, Mahatma Gandhi's seven sins. I could not attempt those questions because I was unaware of these things. So yes, then coming to my optional, I had taken geography as an optional. In geography, I had read the basic books that are there. In paper 1, I had read Savindra Singh. In paper 2, I had read India by Fuller. And I only kept myself restricted to two or three books. I practiced map work, and map work I practiced from the last year question papers, and also after the prelims, IS Baba starts an initiative of daily questions in TLP. So I followed that regularly. In that they give four or five places every day for map marking, so I followed that. I think that helped me. And then after the mains, you have interview. Again, for interview preparation, you have to prepare your DAF properly, because that's one area which they focus on. They ask you about your hobbies, about your extracurricular activities. Apart from that, all the current issues that are going on. Here also, IS Baba has an initiative of interview preparation, so you can follow that. They give very important and very dicey topics like reservations, Supreme Court decisions. So you have to make your own opinion and try to keep your answer as multidimensional as possible. So I think that's my whole.
So your optional is geography. Right. But since 2012, right, 11 or 12, the scores of geography has been.
That's true.
Yeah. Would you still advise your fellow aspirants to take geography?
Yes, you're right. Geography has not been performing well for the past few years. But I think why I took geography, there were two reasons. One, that it helped me heavily in my GS preparation. Almost everything I read in geography helped me in GS in some way or the other. And secondly, I thought it was very relevant as a civil servant. I need to know the geography around me. So that was the reason why I took geography. Now, the thing that it's not performing well, I think this is very, very subjective, because with every subject you have, sometime it performs well, sometime it doesn't. But as long as you are confident that you are thorough with the basics of that subject, I don't think you need to think about which is performing well or which is not performing well. Suppose you take Pub Ad and it performs well this year, there's no guarantee it will perform well next year. But if you are thorough with it, I think you should be confident and go ahead with it. So yes, geography will definitely help you in GS. Especially geography paper 2 is actually like GS paper. They ask you very general questions and it will help you in GS, definitely.
How did IS Baba help you in your preparation?
Like I have mentioned, IS Baba was immensely helpful. I'll be indebted for my life to IS Baba for this, because I did not opt for any coaching in Delhi or in any other city. And this initiative, this online, it reaches to your home, and it every day sort of it gears you up. And there is that peer review thing, and you're always motivated. No, I have to finish. And the most important thing in IS Baba is that you every day you have a daily target. So you're always on your foot. That today I have to finish this quiz, then I have to finish this current affair. So it happened with me that, you know, if this was not there, the whole timetable would have been very haphazard. So all the initiatives, the daily current events, the daily quiz, the ILP, the TLP, the interview preparation thing, everything was very, very helpful to me.
Would you like to tell about ILP?
Yes.
Integrated Learning Program.
Yes. So ILP is a very, very good initiative in terms of the quality of matter, because I remember I had prepared even my geography optional notes from ILP because they had given very good notes on soil of India. So I had completely prepared my geography from there only, and on very important topics like urbanization. In regular books, you don't find that kind of material. It's very appealing also. You feel like you want to read it. Otherwise, in books, you get bored while reading. So I think ILP is very, very good. And it adds to your preparation a lot. Test questions may 60-day plan though is a must for prelims. I think UPSC prepares a question paper from 60-day. I felt that while giving my prelims, because 60-day plan was very, very helpful for prelims. And after prelims, they start that daily questions in TLP. So I followed the geography TLP and also the general studies. Although I could not finish everything, because that was huge to cover, but I did follow that compilations that used to come for everything that I missed, so that I know at least something about that particular topic. So I suggest that you follow that, because that will help you immensely in your GS. Now, since the GS papers are so much current oriented, it's important that you have a practice of writing anything on any issue that is going on, because what happens is sometimes we tend to miss the important point or the key point in that, and we read everything else and miss the, what we say, the bullseye. So it's important that you follow TLP. And in interview preparation also, this time my interview was in March, I followed almost every day the questions that I used to give. I used to form my opinion, and in interview your opinion should be very balanced, it should not be radical, and you should try to be as multidimensional as possible.
Actually, when we started off, our vision was to reach out to every person, yes, in the remotest of the places across the country. So do you think we are on that right track?
Yes.
And if you have any suggestions for us to improve upon, so you can please share it.
Right. I think you are definitely on the right track. I have secured rank 4 only by sitting in my home and following all these online initiatives. And I think many, many more examples are there who have followed this and have gone through, made through this exam. It's very important that people realize that they don't need to spend their time, their money, their health in running here and there, and they can easily sit in the comfort of their homes and follow these online initiatives and crack this exam. Suggestions, I think everything is great in IS Baba. Only thing I can say is that in optionals, maybe you can start giving compilations of the answers after a month or so. And I think in daily, I think it's very good. I don't find, nothing is coming to my mind right now.
Okay, so now the last question is your advice to the fellow aspirants,
right,
and especially since prelims is around the corner.
Yes, yeah. Yes. So my advice to the fellow aspirants would be, like, this exam is actually a marathon, and you really have to be really patient more than anything else throughout this journey. There will be times when you will feel that you cannot do it, you will feel low, but believe me, if you are consistent, if you just have faith in yourself that okay, I am doing honestly my duty and leave everything to God, rest everything to God, I think you will make through. And like, prelims is around the corner, 18 June. So first of all, my best wishes to all of you who are giving prelims this year. Just have faith in yourself, have faith in your hard work, you will be through it. Yeah. Follow 60-day. Yes, IS Baba is definitely the best platform. It has been very, very good to be with IS Baba, and I followed it regularly, and I think it has played a very major role in my selection.
Thank you.
I would definitely like to say that IS Baba is the best online platform. At least for me, it was really helpful for getting rank 4. I would give full credit to IS Baba, and it is the best platform, so you should definitely join it.